Got hit with a copperhead back in Tennessee, and we bled it. It kept tobacco juice on it, and it sucked the poison right out of there.
Two of you, go back in there. Got it. Move.
You even gonna try to save him? Sir, I'll suck it out myself, Mr. Landry.
Shut up, son.
All right, that's enough. Back to work. Go.
You murdered bastard.
Oh, shut up.
The thing about being free is it's awful easy to take for granted until someone snatches it away. I left Tennessee because there weren't nothing there for me no more and headed to New Orleans. Others made their way to Mexican territory. Texas. They called themselves Texians. Some wanted a fresh start. Some figured to make their fortune. Some just craved a good fight. But all of them expected to be free. A general, name of Santa Anna, was president of Mexico and head of the army. They didn't come no more brutal than him. He swore he'd crush their fight for independence. Sam Houston was Santa Anna's mortal enemy. He had to make an army out of men who hated taking orders. Jim Bowie was a legend. He had a worm in his chest from consumption, but he still fought harder than any five men. Hanging in that cage, I never would have guessed our paths would ever cross.
Oh,
here.
Them Frenchies is fierce. I hear they got a prison island off South America somewhere. So bad, men cut their own throats on the way there. Call it Devil's Island. Take a chill on this. Make you right again. Tomorrow your body won't have no memory of that cage. But you gotta quit going up against them Andrew brothers. They're Venus snakes. And that fancy dress one runs guns for the Mexicans. They just soon swat you as a fly.
What's wrong with you? Just let a man die like that.
Regular rules don't have nothing to do with this place.
All right, Allison, Holland, outside. Landy wants y'all. There's a wagon stuck in the mud bank about a half mile down the river. Let me move it down the branch a little bit. Well, I can't untie the damn thing with all that weight on it. Swing it back up around behind me somewhere. Give it some play. Mr. Landry.
He's going for his pistol. Cut shot, are you? The ball's still in there, but it ain't deep. Put your hand on it. Hold it tight.
We're all dead men now.
You best hightail to Mississippi. If we run into you again and you give the law a sniff of where we're at, I'll gut you like a fish.
Can you stand?
Did you have to kill him?
Don't be stupid, boy.
Get them, and you will help me.
I didn't have no idea where we was heading, but I knew Landry would track us like dogs. Hugh figured we could join up with them Texas volunteers, hide out in the army. I didn't want nothing to do with no war, but it was either that or get caught by them Frenchies. And I weren't going back to that cage. Then Hugh told me Houston Dunn promised every man that fought with him 640 acres of land when it was all over. Of course, that was assuming any Texians was still alive by then. I figured land was worth the risk, and like Hugh said, all we had to do was whip the entire Mexican army.
You stole horses from the army?
Andy Jackson's boys can always find more. Them soldiers was drunk. I just waltzed off on them. There's a couple of stores nearby. All I had to do was help myself. Old Sam Colt knew what he was doing when he come up with this one. Fire off 5 rounds faster you can cock the hammer.
I can't go on no more, Hugh.
Yes, I can. But right now, you gotta do some drinking. This is gonna hurt, son. We'll hold up here a few days till you can ride.
You know what cured me of working for a living? Mining, underground, filthiest job a man could have.
Yeah, you told me about 5 times.
Probably Choctaws, which means we'll get something to eat, place to sleep tonight.
I ain't eating with no savages. Don't want nothing to do with them.
Listen, there ain't nothing more savage than a white man.
Thieves.
We want a trade. We bought them in Louisiana.
Soldiers no sell horses. Where you get?
Same place you got yours. We'll give you 1 horse for food and a gun with powder and shot.
Come, we smoke.
No, no. We ain't here to bargain. We want food and a gun.
Wait out here.
While you swap off my horse?
Only man come. Boy, stay.
Otepa! Otepa!
Isuba!
Baladichi!
Get out of here!
What'd that thief give you for my horse?
He ain't exactly just your horse.
Well, what'd you trade him for? You surprised you still got your britches on?
Turkey?
No.
I'm letting him have both horses.
You what?
Can't go riding him across Texas with stolen brands nohow. He give us one of his dwellings. All the food we want, and we can stay as long as we need to.
Don't seem like much of a trade to me.
He thrown in that Tonkawa woman, the cook and toad for us.
I should have figured.
There's Santa. Iron Jacket told me she was stolen by some Mexicans. Traded her to him for two horses. Give him one of them both. He ain't had no venison since he got stuck in jail.
Sure you want this in our tent tonight?
We'll treat her a lot better than those Choctaws will, and she knows it. There ain't nothing worse than being a woman prisoner of other squaws.
I might sleep on my knife tonight anyways.
I'm planning to sleep on something else.
Something in this don't taste like deer to me.
You put some dog in it, give it a little variety.
Figured. But you get out of here! It ain't it with you staring at me like that?
There wasn't no call for that.
Well, I told you, I don't care for no Indians.
Hell, you ain't old enough to fought any of them. What makes...
I'm old enough to remember coming home to find our cabin burned to the ground. Mom, Pa laying out in the horse loft. Their hair gone and... hogs chewing on their insides.
Who done it?
Sheriff said it was probably some drunk Shawnees.
Well, that was Tennessee, son. We're in Texas now. Different Indians is different.
Not to me.
Sweetheart. Just relax. This won't take a minute.
Years.
Don't tell that crazy woman nothing. Hell, I just wanted a poke.
Men? The men who stole me?
like them.
Gotta be some San Hans boys.
What are they doing here?
My guess is they make these Indians steal horses for them.
What do they get?
They get to live.
They let Iron Jacket keep half what he steals.
¿Dónde están los americanos?
Asesinaron para obtener estos caballos. No soy un estúpido. Lo robaron del ejército.
He wants to know what we're doing here and who we killed to get them horses. He said we stole them from the army.
Tell him we rode them horses in from Louisiana. What we done before them ain't any of his damn business.
Estábamos en Louisiana. Y los ganamos en un juego de cartas con un sargento borracho.
Romero, ve por los caballos.
Disculpe, teniente. Es un pobre muchacho ignorante. Lo siente mucho.
What'd you tell him?
You're just an ignorant country boy who's a little soft in the head. It ain't your fault your brain ain't quite whole. Told him you're real sorry, ain't you? Ain't you, son?
Sorry.
Presidente nos espera con los caballos.
Está bien. Since you had so few horses for us last month, I'm taking all but six.
Salud, Lieutenant. I would like to meet with El Presidente.
Well, Iron Jacket wants to get even with them Mexicans today. Wants to filch all them horses back and any others they got beside.
You said we'd go?
Damn right. We help him, we get six good horses from the ones we steal.
I go with you. You no stop me. I give you something.
rifle, metal ball, fire dust. I hide.
Here. A Kentucky. I hear David Crockett can hit the eye out of a turkey at 100 yards with one of these.
We take the rifle.
Like hell you will.
You use knife on Mexicans.
It's like talking to my dead granny. You people do whatever you want to with your pickets. We're gonna pig string ours so they don't get loosed. Now let's get moving.
Move on.
Go.
Move it.
Boca abajo.
Stand on the ground.
Por favor, señor. No nos maten, por favor.
Por favor de Dios.
No hicimos nada.
No hicimos nada, señor.
Podemos quedar. Callado, por favor.
What are they doing?
No, no.
Ain't our business. We done our end of it. Take the horses we got coming to us.
Don't leave Mexicans to tell.
We got six head coming. These Mexicans get trussed up and that's it.
Here.
Thank you.
French, he ain't got no quit in him, does he? Go. Looks like as good a place to cross as any. Son, you lead the way.
They don't teach you swimming in Kentucky.
I meant to do that.
What Indians done to you that's so bad?
What are you talking about?
You know what I say.
But whatever they done, it'll make no difference now.
What they done?
Some drunk Shawnees killed my folks back in Tennessee.
Who's Shawnee?
You really don't know, do you? Anyways, don't make no difference now. All them people's gone. All I care about is getting away from Emil Landry, joining up with Houston, getting my 640 acres.
Hugh know what to do.
Hugh? I seem to remember a time he didn't. Somebody went upside his head with a stick of firewood.
Don't swim good either.
You two set up camp over by the river. I'll take the horses into town.
Well, what? That don't make no sense. You going into town all on your own?
I've been trading since before you was born. I don't need no help. Well,
just don't trade them horses off for a bottle of rot gut.
I'll see, can I keep my wits about me?
It's the only shirt I got till Hugh comes back with one. How'd you learn to talk English when you were stolen by the Mexicans?
Mexicans not take me from Tancahuas. Americans did. Long then, they give me to Mexicans for
magic water and gun.
When was this?
4 years long ago.
Americans done this?
When I was running with Micah J. Harp and his gang, they didn't care no more about killing a man than stepping on a frog. When Micah J. finally got his rope, some sheriff put a ball in his spine. He was flopping around in the dirt like a fish thrown up on the bank.
That's a hell of a story, you. Never be ashamed of that one.
What do we do for you fellas?
Chasing the doe in them woods back there. You seen her come out?
No, sir, we didn't see no deer.
You've been short on meat a while now.
You can have what's left of our coffee and some jerky. Ain't got much else.
Boys. Where you fellas headed?
Why are you interested?
Just figured if it's going to San Antonio, maybe we could head that way together.
Looks to me like you've taken some scalps of late.
Got jumped by Comanche a while back. You get madder than hell when you shoot their buffalo.
Well, we're fixing to ride out, mister. You can come along if you like, but we're planning on camping early. My partner here's got a boil on his butt. Don't let him ride too far in a day.
Well, we'll just get together before dark then.
Tell the one on the left I got the others.
You could be wrong.
I ain't. I've been with too many of their kind.
About what they had in mind for us, let alone for Santa.
You're on your own, so you better tell me why you were dogging us.
He's gonna kill you, take your supplies and animals. The man your partner shot wanted to squaw.
I reckon we'll get it out of him the engine way. What do you say to that, Santa?
Tell.
Say goodbye to it forever.
All right. I got a Frenchie named Emo Landry. He's got $200 out. Only to you.
Where do you see this Frenchie?
A saloon in San Felipe, about 20 miles from here.
When?
Day before last. We're supposed to pickle your heads in a jar and deliver them that way.
Bastard, you thought I was being cruel to?
What do we do about him?
Kill him.
She's right. He knows who we are and where we're at.
Hugh!
I told you what you wanted to know.
Killing's gotta stop somewhere. My city's half the vote here.
Where'd you get this black hair you got hanging around your neck?
Tuck it off a Comanche buck.
He lies. Could never kill Comanche.
All right. I cut it off a squaw I used to tow for us.
Reckon I got off easy when she went upside my head with that firewood.
Santa?
He's out gathering some firewood. We've got something a little prickly we got to talk about. Santa can't go no further with us.
What?
Use your head, son. She sure can't go into the army with us. If them others catch us first, you know what they'll do to her.
What are we supposed to do? Just leave her out here?
We can give her a horse and some food. I heard there's a Tonkawa camp over by the Brazos. Wouldn't take her 2 days to get there.
No! I ain't gonna do it! Not now! We're still a few days away from them Texians. She could stay with
us. Damn it, son, you ain't hearing me. She can't come with us. I'll tell her if you want me to. She'll take it from me without no complaint.
Something I gotta tell you. You can't go no further with us.
You not want me to?
No. It's just... with these men after us, we gotta get with Houston. And his men. And there just ain't no way.
All right.
No. No, it ain't. I'm gonna come back for you. After we're done soldiering, and if this war turns out right, I'm gonna have 640 acres of land, too.
You go away. Be like other Americans. It's not bad.
No. I'm not like other Americans. I'm a convict.
About Mackage's favorite thing, skinning men he didn't like. Start by slicing off the soles of their feet. Ho! This way! Come on! Thank you.
We want to join up. Them boys is gun runners from Santa Ana.
Men, halt. State your business. I said, state your business.
A viento.
Fairly dramatic entrance, gentlemen.
Yes, General, I'm Hugh Allison. This here's...
Come home. Speak to my own darn self, Hugh.
How were those men after you?
Well, you see, General, me and the boy here come up on them and a bunch of Mexican
General
soldiers
Houston,
and looked to me like they were selling guns.
General, them men was after us because we're escaped convicts from Louisiana.
Oh, hell, son.
We killed a guard over there, and now his brother's got $200 on our heads.
Why were you in prison?
One of them Louisiana rich men's women lost her purse and said I stole it. And they gave me 10 years.
You guilty of that crime?
No, sir, I wasn't.
I killed a man in a card game. He wasn't much of a man.
Card sharp either, for that matter.
You know good as I do, General, you can't let a man steal your money.
Can't argue with that, Sam. Hugh Allison?
Look here! Jim Booth!
Been a long time, Hugh.
Well, it's hard getting out of them Louisiana chain gangs sometimes.
Well, what I heard, you is never gonna see Texas again.
Well, we heard y'all might need a little help liberating Texas.
You got that right, Hugh.
I see you two are acquainted.
Hell yes, General. I met old Jim here when he owned a sugar plantation down in Louisiana. And then he killed a man in a duel, and the two of us lit out for Texas in 1828, I believe it was. Is that about right?
Oh, you got a good recollector for having your head stove in as much as it was.
What can we do for you, Mr. Allison?
You want to join up with your Texans.
That's so. This is Dev Smith, my chief scout.
Howdy.
Howdy.
Why do you want to join the army?
General, I hear you've given 640 acres to any soldier that would stick it out to the end. I could get me a real good start with that, General. It'd give me something I could work and be proud of.
What about you, Mr. Allison?
I won't lie to you, General. Me and the boy need to keep that Frenchie off our backs. But we're both good fighting men, and from what I heard, we wouldn't be the only ones in your army who had a few scrapes with the law.
He's got a point there, Sam.
Well, we need men who are not going to run at the first sign of trouble. Can I depend on your loyalty?
You got my word.
You can count on that.
Might as well.
Well, all right, all you need to do is sign this pledge here, then.
Come on over and make your mark right here.
Welcome, son.
Mr. Bowie.
From this moment on, any troubles you've had in the past are no concern of mine. You are soldiers now. You may enjoy fighting for just cause rather than yourselves. It's nice to have you on our side, gentlemen. Nice to have you on our side.
Then we could drink to that.
You can drink to that.
So there's me and Hugh, and we are both just horse-kissing drunk. And somehow, we're playing cards with Jean Lafitte, a black-hearted pirate who would kill his mother for a gold tooth. And the scariest part is, we're winning!
We had to play cards till 7 in the morning just to lose to this. And then we celebrated with a Kentucky breakfast.
What's a Kentucky breakfast?
3-pound steak, bottle of whiskey, and a dog.
What's a dog for?
Eat the steak. Anyhow, me and Jim got some cigars and went down to this pit by the river.
They had an alligator down there that was thick around as a horse.
And Jim jumped on that sucker and rode him into the marketplace. He fed him a meat pie at the cafe.
Oh, sure, you ain't a stretching the truth. Just a bite.
I got to drink a little more whiskey. My gullet greased. So did Hugh ever tell you that he used to ride with the Harp Gang?
Only 100 times.
I bet he didn't tell you about being a sheriff over in Arkansas.
Damn, Jim, you're gonna ruin my reputation.
He's a lawman?
Yeah, for about a minute.
It was a breeze after mining. But the pay was poor and I had to live in a town.
That's it, Annie.
He won't bite you.
I heard stories about this knife. I didn't know if it was real or not.
Oh, it's real, all right. There's plenty of men underground could testify to that.
Tell me something, Mr. Jim Bowie. You really good with that there knife? Is it safe? I don't know, sir. Probably not.
Hey, Jim, tell them about that Creole gal. One with a gold tooth.
You know, Sam wants me to go blow up the mission. Bring the men back up here to join him.
Maybe me and Son ought to go with you.
No. You guys got to stay here. Sam's gonna need the both of you. We don't stop Santa Ana down there, he's gonna blow through East Texas like a hurricane. I can't allow that. And Crockett, some of them others agree with me, so we're gonna go down there and fortify the positions and try to buy Sam some time to consolidate his forces.
Don't sound like much of a future to me, Jim. Maybe you ought to think it over.
I have thought it over. My mind's made up. I'd appreciate it if you'd watch my dress hat for me. Things is different now, Hugh. All that carousing, all that hell raising we done, I'm done with that. This here is the most important place in the country right now. And I'm a part of it. We're all gonna be part of history, Hugh. You know the best thing? We're on the right side.
Senor Landry, what an unexpected pleasure.
Pleasure is mine, Capitan. Didn't realize that the Mexican army owned any ranches this far north.
Ah, yes, we have liberated it from a Texian, Mr. Willis. He has been very accommodating. Now, what brings you all this way?
I need to speak to the Presidente.
Captain, who is this and what is his business?
This is Senor Landry from Louisiana. El Presidente. He is the one who has been so helpful supplying us with weapons.
Senor Landry, I'm delighted to meet you at last. Please, accept my condolences for your brother. A horrible tragedy.
Merci. Presidente, I have come to ask a personal favor. I want to ride with you against Houston's Texians.
Fire! Front rank to the rear, march!
Compañero. Thanks, Tom.
Well, you get your men together and get back here as soon as possible.
Yeah. Take real good care of yourself.
Yeah, you too.
Oh, Hugh. It's been damn good to see you, partner. Remember what I told you. History's watching. Thank you, son. You know, pay attention to that old rooster there. You might learn something. My boy.
I've come to San Antonio, sir. I've got a letter here for the general.
What you got there?
I got a letter, General.
Lieutenant Burnett assembled the men on a drill field.
Officers, call!
Officers, call!
Gather around, men.
San Antonio has been under siege almost a week. Santa Ana has moved anywhere from 3,000 to 6,000 troops around the Alamo Mission. Many of you have friends behind those walls. Everything in our hearts urges us to go immediately to the aid of our countrymen. But there is more at stake than the fate of San Antonio now. The fate of Texas itself lies in our hands. If we join them, we may give them temporary relief, but there is no chance for a victory. We will open up the whole of the south of Texas to invasion and defeat, and there'll be nothing to stop Santa Ana from marching to the Louisiana border. We must all have faith in our friends to hold the mission long beyond the limits of ordinary men. I know the pain you all must feel at these words, but I ask each one of you to stay here with me.
The general's point was clear. We should stay put. But Bowie was at the Alamo. There weren't no other choice for us.
quotidiano.
Que Dios me perdone.
Edimiti,
Santo Padre.
Figured I'd have to be dead before I seen hell.
Hey! What the hell do you think you're doing? Hey!
No, señor, por favor, no! Hey. No, no,
what the hell do you think you're doing?
Speak American, damn it!
Don't, son. Don't. These boys ain't no soldiers. Their job's to follow Santa Ana, do this dirty work for him.
They're all killed, ain't they, Hugh? Every last one of them.
Right. We're with General Houston. You're gonna be all right now.
Why didn't you come? We waited and waited for you. Where were you? Susanna Dickinson. My husband was Lieutenant Elmer Dickinson. They came in waves, as far as I could see. The sharpshooters on the walls fired point blank into their faces, and they kept coming. They threw back their ladders and stabbed their heads with bayonets. They kept coming. They just kept coming. My husband was shot through the head, right next to me. It spun him around to face me. He just looked so surprised. It was a massacre. It's like they were drunk on all the blood. They were chopping up dead men with their swords, lifting them up on their bayonets. I saw David Crockett and three of his men get hacked to death against one of the walls. But he said no help was coming. No one wanted to surrender. They would not surrender. You have to understand that. Santa Ana spared me. He gave me this for General Houston.
Jim Bowie.
It's in the infirmary.
Get moving, Hugh. General's gonna want to know what happened here.
Look what they done to my friend.
Mrs. Dickinson, please go with Lieutenant Burnett. He'll make you as comfortable as possible under the circumstances. I think best you travel with us.
Santa Ana says he will pardon any Texian who lays down his arms, otherwise we'll all get what they got at the Alamo.
We retreat to the east.
Sir? Retreat? How the hell are we supposed to...
When word of the Alamo gets out across Texas, more patriots will want to join us down the trail. We need all the men we can get. Then we choose the place to stop and make a stand. Now I want you three to scout out Santa Ana. You find them, you catch up with us. Now I'm counting on you.
The general took them east. They kept pushing for weeks in all kinds of weather. It were wearing, but the general was right. More men joined up along the way. Them Texians weren't used to running. They hated not knowing when they was gonna stop and fight. Meanwhile, Hugh, Def, and me got lucky.
Santa Ana was supposed to be some kind of hotshot military man. He's got his boys blocked on two sides by the marsh, and all of them having to charge over that little bitty bridge if they want to cross the river.
I count 15 wagons. Most of them look like ammunition. I didn't see but one field piece down there, and it looks like a 12-pounder. Some of that infantry is Zapadoras, which means this is probably the same bunch that killed everybody at the Alamo.
I see one good reason why the general ain't alert. Got a good-looking senorita down there. Appears to me he'd been doing some serious poking. That son, to the right of the command tent.
Thought he would have thrown it in by now.
least we can kill him now and not get hung for murder.
So you see, General, he's practically put his men in a box. If we'd had a field piece, we could have blowed grape shot all over the camp.
Yes, but did you see Santa Ana?
So we seen him all right. Looked pretty relaxed, too.
Well, we need to move out right now. I ought to reach this forest and be in position to attack by midday tomorrow. I understand you did some mining in Kentucky. Did you handle explosives?
Yes, sir, I did.
All right, so good. I want you and son to blow up this bridge so they don't have an escape.
Yes, sir.
Gentlemen, the time has finally come.
And 1,500 troops. Now, they outnumber us 2-1, but they have never been attacked before, and they do not expect us to do it now. It is 3:00. They are in their siesta, and our attack will catch them in disarray. Now, each of you know what will happen if we are not victorious today. The enemy will sweep through East Texas and devastate the colonies. They must not leave the field. Think of the fate of your loved ones if we are unsuccessful this afternoon. If you are faint at heart at what we must do, you must remember the Alamo. Let that be your cry, let that be your cry, let that be your cry. Remember the Alamo. Remember the Alamo.
Aim! Fire! partir ahora. Si usted no se va, todo se pierde.
Come on. It's taken a long time. Now, you will bear for my brother.
Come on!
They called it the Battle of San Jacinto. It lasted 18 minutes. 630 Mexican soldiers died, and we took another 700 or so prisoner. We lost 9 men, and 30 was wounded. We thought Santa Ana got away, and that meant it weren't really over. But the next day, a couple of boys went hunting for a deer and come back with El Presidente.
Move! Underlay!
He was hiding in a canebrake, pretending to be a peasant.
Touch this man. He'll be treated with respect due him as the president of his country and the leader of the Mexican army. General Santa Anna, on behalf of the Republic of Texas, I will accept your surrender.
General accepted his surrender, and I accepted my 640 acres.
Yeah!
Well, this is where I head north. I'm thinking I want you to have this. Help you remember what we were a part of. Things are best kept indoors. So long, son. You get up my way, you come by and see me. You'd be welcome.
Will you?
You heard about a river in Colorado called the Platte, where a man could pan float gold nuggets as big as elk's teeth. He was tired of fighting and running. He just wanted some peace. And I knew just where I was going, too.